One of the most intimidating things when it comes to creating a profitable Facebook and Instagram ads campaign is actually setting up the campaign inside of Facebook's ads manager. In this video here, I'm going to be taking you inside of Facebook's ads manager and show you step by step how to actually set the campaign up. How do you set a campaign up so that you're setting yourself up for success inside of ads manager? There are three different elements of your campaign setup: campaigns, ad sets, and ads. Let's dive in. To access Ads Manager, which is where you set your campaigns up, I'm gonna show you two different ways to do that. The first way is from your Facebook page. In the upper right-hand corner of your Facebook page, you're gonna see a little create link, and you can click on the create link, and then the second option down, you wanna click on add. The other way, if you wanna go directly to Ads Manager, you can go to business.facebook.com/ads manager. And from there, you can click on the create button as well, and that will take you to the exact same screen that we're looking at here. You'll notice on the left-hand side here, these are the three elements of your campaign setup. It starts with the campaign level, then there's the ad set level, and then there's the ad level. I liken this to Russian dolls, where you have a large doll, then you have a smaller one that fits into that larger one, and then the next smaller one fits into that next larger one, which fits into the overall one. I liken the Facebook campaign setup very similarly, because the ads are within the ad sets, which are within the campaign. And don't worry if you're like, what are you talking about, Rick? I'm gonna break this down for you step by step. So at the campaign level, you're choosing the objective. And as you can see on the screen here, Facebook breaks it down into three different categories: awareness, consideration, and conversion. So these are the different points of the sales funnel. You need to be clear on what your goal is for the campaign. What do you want to accomplish with your ads? Why are you running ads in the first place? For example, I want to run ads to build my email list so that I can do a sale of my product next month. So in that case there, I want to tell Facebook that my objective is conversions, because what that means is Facebook will show your ad to the people within your target audience who are most likely to take that action. In this case here, convert, meaning click on your ad, go to your landing page, and actually opt in or register or whatever it is, meaning the conversion. So let's just say in this example here, we're gonna choose the conversions objective. That's step number one of the campaign level. I'm choosing an objective. The next thing I wanna do is give my campaign a name. So I'm gonna call this test social media examiner lead generation. There's no right or wrong, by the way, on the campaign name. You just want to name it something so that when you see it inside of Ads Manager, you know exactly what this campaign is. So we're just going to click on continue. That's all you have to do at the campaign level. Now we go into the ad set level. This is where you are telling Facebook what you actually want to optimize the campaign for. This is really the meat and potatoes of your campaign setup. So the first thing that you wanna do at the ad set level is give your ad set a name. In this case here, I wanna target fans of Social Media Examiner. So my ad set name, I'll put SME, and then I'm gonna say, I want this to run in US and Canada, and we're gonna do all placements. The next field that's really critical to our campaign setup is to choose the conversion event. We wanna tell Facebook which conversion we actually want Facebook to optimize the campaign for. So in our hypothetical example here, we want more opt-ins. So we wanna send people from our Facebook ad to our opt-in page. And then when they get to our opt-in page, they give us their name and their email address, and then they land on our thank you page. Well, the thank you page marks the conversion. So we want to tell Facebook, we want more of those conversions. This is where our custom conversion comes in, and we wanna choose the custom conversion that we have set up previous to this step from the drop down here. If you don't know what I'm talking about when it comes to a custom conversion, there's a link in the description below the video here to an article that walks you through step by step what a custom conversion is and how to set the custom conversion up. So in this case here, I'm gonna choose my custom conversion from the drop down list. The next set that I'm gonna get to is the audience targeting. I'm gonna choose my age range of, let's just say 25 plus. I'm gonna do both men and women, and I'm gonna choose US and Canada. And so meaning I wanna target people who are in the US and Canada, and then go down to the age, detailed targeting. This is the stereotypical targeting that people think of when they think of Facebook ads targeting, meaning I want to target people who are fans of such and such. In this example here, let's target fans of Social Media Examiner. I'm going to type in Social Media Exam, and it should come up here. Boom. Interest. There's my option here. Okay, I'm going to uncheck the expand detailed targeting criteria. What we want to look at here, since we are targeting fans of Social Media Examiner, in the upper right hand corner here where it says potential reach, it says 980,000 people. This is one big mistake that I see people make. Their audience is too small and I'm getting 980,000 people. Let's add in, let's see, Mari Smith. There we go. And now we're at 1 million people. I want to try to get our potential reach to somewhere between 1 million and 3 or 4 million people. We want to give as much data to Facebook as possible to work with here. Now, here's the caveat. If you're a local business or if you're in a country with a smaller population, do the best that you can. You're not going to reach 1 million people. Try to get that potential audience reach as big as possible while still being as targeted as possible for the audience that you want to reach. Now, this next section, as we scroll down here, is the connections targeting. Connections is basically people who are connected to your Facebook page. If you have at least a few thousand Facebook fans on your page and they're targeted, then I would target your Facebook fans within your Facebook campaign setup. I would put them into their own ad set though. In this, I'm gonna put my page here. I'm targeting Social Media Examiner, Mari Smith. I don't wanna target my fans because I'm gonna be targeting my fans in another ad set. That way I'm avoiding the overlap there. As I scroll down here, the next section in the ad set level is the placements section. The placements section is basically all the different properties between Facebook and Instagram. So Facebook's mobile newsfeed, Facebook's desktop newsfeed, Instagram newsfeed, Instagram stories. These are all the placements that you get to choose. And what I recommend that you choose is, and it says here on the screen, recommended is to do automatic placements. So the last section here in your ad set setup is the budget and schedule. The first thing that you want to do where it says optimization for ad delivery, and it defaults to conversions. That's what you want to choose because remember, our objective at the campaign level is conversions. So we want to choose conversions and it defaults to that. Where it says cost control, I would recommend leaving that blank. So then we get to the budget and scheduling option. And this is where you have two different options, the daily budget and the lifetime budget. I recommend choosing the daily budget option. Everybody always wants to know, well, Rick, how much should I spend on my ads in order to see results? And there's two different answers there. The easy answer is spend as much as you can afford. I recommend at least $10 a day. If you're more advanced and you know roughly what your cost per lead is, Facebook's algorithm wants to see that you are gonna get about 50 conversions a week. That is about 7 conversions per day. So if you know that your cost per lead is about $5 and you need 7 conversions per day, then your budget should be about $35 a day. And it should get you the recommended number of conversions over the 7-day time period. In this example here, I'll put $20 as my daily budget. The next option here is I can set a start and end date. You need to start them as soon as you're ready. The best time, in my opinion, is start my ads as early as possible in the day. That way I'm giving Facebook's algorithm the full day to really start to get me results. In this case here, I'm gonna choose the run my ad set continuously starting today. And then the next option here is the conversion window. What I recommend that you do here is choose the 1 day click option. Facebook wants to know how long should it take to take the action that you want them to take once they land on your landing page. For the final two options here, just leave ad scheduling and delivery type as they are, and you are now set up for the ad set level. Now I'm going to click the continue button, and now I go to the third level of our campaign setup, which is the ad level. This is where we set up the actual ad that we are going to run. The first thing you want to do is name our ad. Let's just say Rick at Whiteboard Teaching. I'm going to call it V1s because I might have a couple of different versions. As I scroll down here, the next section is the identity section. This is basically making sure that you are connected to both your Facebook page and your Instagram. You would just choose from the drop downs here. The next section here, this is where you're actually creating the
ad.
And it defaults to the create ad section, and it defaults to the single image or video option, which is what we're gonna do in this example. So we're choosing the single image or video. As you scroll down here, it's you choose image. And this is where you have the option to upload images that you've created. You can browse the library of images if you already have uploaded images previously, or you can choose from the free stock images that Facebook has. In this example here, I'm gonna choose from our library. And I'm gonna scroll down and I'm gonna grab an image from our board here. Here it is. Here's me teaching at the whiteboard. Click on continue, and here is the image. As we scroll down here, you can see the preview of our ad start to take shape. Now, in the first section here, where it says primary text, this is our what we call our ad copy. This is the copy that goes above the image. So I'll just put in test ad copy, just so you can see where it shows up in our preview. So you can see here, it comes above the image. The next option here is our headline. The headline is the largest text in our entire ad, and that is very important. I can say test headline goes here. It will show up in the preview here. The description is copy right where it says newsfeed link description. This is only going to show up when the ad is running in the Facebook's desktop newsfeed. I would recommend having some description here. Don't get carried away with it. You can say test description here. The next thing I wanna do is choose the URL. We wanna tell people where we wanna send people to from our ad. I'll just put in my website, rickmulready.com. So this would be opt-in one. When they click on my ad, they go to my opt-in page to opt in for my free download. The display link is optional. I can just have rickmulready.com, and you can see here it goes right above the headline there. And then the call to action, you can see here I have lots of different calls to action to choose from. I recommend using the learn more option. The languages don't need to do anything in that field there. And then the final section at the very bottom is the tracking. Just make sure it's tracking with your pixel that you've set up. Now, I wanna go back up to two different things here. I chose my image here. It's 1080 by 1080 pixels. Well, you can see this option here where it says select a placement to customize. Since I'm running in all placements, as you can see here, I want to make sure that my image is going to look good inside of that specific placement. So what I can do there is select that placement, and I can check to see, is that image gonna look good? And if it doesn't, I can change the copy, I can crop the image if I need to. So this image looks pretty good here. Facebook did a good job in resizing that image for me. Other thing that you can do here is you can see all these different options here. These are previews of what these ads will, what the ad will look like in the different placements. So for example, the desktop newsfeed, you can see it's gonna look a little bit different than say desktop right column. So here's the desktop right column image. So we've reached the bottom of our ad setup here. The next thing we wanna do is we wanna click on confirm. What that's gonna do is that's gonna submit it to Facebook for approval, and it will show up under the delivery as in review. That means that Facebook is reviewing it, and then once they have approved it, then it will show as active, and boom, there you have it. Step by step, exactly how to set up a high converting Facebook and Instagram ads campaign inside of Ads Manager. Now, if you remember, the real meat and potatoes of our campaign setup was at the ad set level, and that's where we set up our targeting, which is super important to ensure that we're attracting our exact target audience. And along with the targeting goes with the audience size. And so I wanna break this down for you, which I'm gonna do in the next video. So make sure to click on the video on the screen here where I'm gonna be taking you through Facebook's ads targeting to ensure that you're attracting your ideal audience for your Facebook and Instagram ads. We'll see you inside of that video.